Hello, I'm Mayank from Indian Institute of Management Trichy. Today I will speak on the condition of direct taxation in India and why there is a requirement of tax reforms. On April 29, 2016, India's Income Tax Department released tax statistics after a gap of almost 16 years. Till 2000, the tax department used to publish the data, but it discontinued for some unknown reasons. The facts revealed in income tax data are shocking. Any observer of Indian economy would find it difficult to believe the extent of poor tax collection in India. Only 1% of population paid tax on their earnings in fiscal 2013. In 2015-16, only 51 million, that is 4%, filed income tax returns. It is important to note that the number of actual taxpayers is much lower because many have declared their earnings below the tax threshold. Over half of the tax returns have zero tax liability. In fiscal 2013, there were only 18,500 individuals and corporate together who paid income tax in excess of rupees 10 million. Only 8 individuals paid tax between rupees 500 million to 1 billion, and only 3 individuals paid taxes more than 3 billion. Thus, the overall growth rate in collection of the direct taxes is lower than the growth rate in nominal GDP. Several conclusions can be inferred from these statistics. First, the wealthy Indians and big corporations are not paying adequate direct taxes, and there is a complete mismatch between the growing number of dollar millionaires and billionaires in India and tax revenue receipts. Second, our tax administration is still not free from corruption and abuse of power. Despite 2 decades of reforms in tax administration, it is widespread public perception that our tax administration is full of corruption and so India need to collect taxes if India wants to become a superpower by 2020. But with these standard of taxes, India cannot become a developed country by 2020. India cannot build one world-class public infrastructure and eradicate poverty from external financing alone. The fulfillment of basic needs of the masses requires substantial financial resources. Domestic resource mobilization through progressive taxation should play the lead role in achieving these development goals. While the proposed GST is expected to broaden the base of indirect taxes, comprehensive administrative and legal reforms are required to curb massive evasion of direct taxes in India. So, what needs to be done? The recent data released on direct taxes pertaining to 3 years shows taxes performed on capital gains to be of the order of 54,000 crore. A senior official of CBDT is on record as having said that tax loss due to abuse of capital gains tax exemption would be to the tune of rupees 80,000 crore this fiscal year. If we want to keep these gains tax exempt, let's have a uniform holding requirement of 3 years across all asset classes. Our generosity extends not just to capital gains but to income tax payers as well. The minimum threshold below which no income tax is paid is rupees 2.5 lakh. This is 250% of India's per capita gross domestic product. That makes India one of the most generous exempters in the world. In most countries, income tax becomes payable when your income is about one half or one fourth of the average income in your country. Indeed, in Russia, you pay income from the very first ruble that you earn. With such a generous exemption, it is no wonder that only 3% of Indians pay income tax. This tax paying class is so politically active that the exemption slabs keep creeping up every year. What we probably need is a drastic reduction in the exemption slab, say to 1 lakh. Of course, the applicable rate in the lower slabs should remain low. Income tax payers have 2 paid concerns. That's why are you letting agriculture income go tax free? Second, they say, when everyone is paying such steep taxes in the form of value added tax, excise and service tax, why do you want to hike income taxes? Both these are misguided. First, only 14% of national income is from the agriculture and land sector. Almost 95% of the farmers hold land less than 2 hectares. So even if they get a very good productivity, they will not be able to contribute a lot to the GDP of India, and thus taking taxes from agriculture sector is not at all an option. India's ratio of direct to indirect taxes is 1:2, and then you cannot talk to increase the indirect taxes and reduce the direct taxes. This ratio is exactly opposite of the advanced economies. Paying direct to income tax should be considered as a membership fee for this robustly functioning democracy. That's the way of reducing the wide gap between our political and fiscal democracy. By becoming a society which is more tax compliant, we will be a more progressive society. We will be contributing more to the government, and we will be helping them in eradicating poverty and becoming India a superpower in the next 15-20 years. So this is my view on the tax reforms in India, and I think it is very necessary at this point of time to think about some of these reforms. Thank you very much.